you very much for asking me to take part in this. I'm looking forward to a little chat about it in a bit. I'll just read some poems from my newest book, which is, I have to give you a little bit of a preamble. All the poems' titles are the English translations of long words in various languages. And it's inspired by a Turkish word, which is Czechoslovakia, Lishtarunak, Diklaramiz, Danmesiniz, which means, are you one of those whom we couldn't make to be originating from Czechoslovakia? So there's some fantastic words from various languages like Czech, Finnish, Slovak, Hungarian, Georgian. So I'm going to read two poems from this series, which I thought maybe resonated with this project a little bit. I've just got to find one of them, no? So this is a Hungarian word, and it means for your plural continued behaviour, as if you could not be desecrated. So, the never tired, the owl and the auger, leather pressed through until the light showed, and continued behaviour that tastes like lighter fluid, as if you were not overly sleepless, as if not fortunate and symbolic, as if you could not be desecrated like all of us other sacreds, jumping for proper money, able to read the signs that tell us indeed what the penury should be like. We don't have a lens through which to view our behaviour as others see it, we just have to imagine. And then the good King Wenceslas looked out, and I dreamed that man flirted with me till he fell over drunk, and I slunk away, skittered in a pool of surplus Shiraz, burnt in a wicker basket set up for such things. I had another hand to hand, just waiting in my pocket. Now I have frequent ball aches, without the balls to speak of. And such a lot of drooping drool over tooth and gum, gutted, I can't be with you tonight, darling, your owl and your auger and your continued behaviours. Dear God, look upon me kindly with your unknowable, unsubstantial, unverifiable looks in your hot sauce. Bring this desecration back to life. The second poem I'm going to read is an Arabic word, which I think is the longest word in the Quran. Apparently, according to Wikipedia, it might not be. But this means, in translation into English, it's, did we ask you to give it to us to drink? It's almost as good as this other one I'll just share with the title of this one. To the least able to be making less understandable, which is a Czech word. And the hatch the bullet flies out of when exiting a tunnel, an Estonian word. So this is, did we ask you to give it to us to drink? It was a candelabra in flame, and you could get up to your neck in it. Like the liquid you'd find at the all-night one-stop, you'd pick up five pizzas to share, hit the latter part of the night with competitive egg throwing. More wine needed, more skins of wine. This was when they had skins instead of bottles, better to carry across large distances like Arabic, the route ingrained internally after very many years of travelling back and forth across the land and the brain. There is a part of the brain where habit is consigned to. It knows instinctively the route between the spa and the flat, very drunk already. A bottle raised to the light contains multitudes of implicit things which ultimately are forgotten again, just vague feelings of nuanced topics. What about baking versus cooking? What about the glass ceiling? What about Nigel Farage? What about whether you're a night owl or an early bird? What about what name a couple should give their child? Such conversational stuff is wheeled out. I forgot whether we asked you already. Did I forget how many people were in the room? When I am not thinking, am I forgetting? And is this the real reason I cannot sleep? Because I'm afraid of my mind going blank, and then in that space I might forget everything. Otherwise, each new year I remember. Thank you. Oh, that's